Still continuing, we have V. This time we are given B squared plus AC minus AB minus BC, and then all over C squared minus AC plus AB minus BC. The solution here remains the same. Follow the principles. Factorize the numerator and then of course the denominator. So our B squared plus AC minus AB minus BC will actually be equal to, pairing this and pairing that, we have here B squared and AC have nothing in common. That's it. So this is a good one. So if you pair them like this, it does not work. So we rearrange. We rearrange our terms. So rearrange. When we rearrange, we can have B squared minus AB plus AC minus BC. Now let's pair this again and see what will happen. In this case, we have B common. What remains is B minus A. Then here we have C common. What remains is A minus B. Now watch this expression. Just like the previous one that I just saw. This is B minus A. This is A minus B. So we can write this one as B into minus A plus B plus C into A minus B. Alright. I want to bring out this minus out. So it will become minus B. And then I will write A here. I'm taking the minus. Minus and plus here will become what? A minus. And then this is B. And then plus C into A minus B. Beautiful. So you can now see that A minus B and A minus B are common. And we have introduced this, have been able to modify this to be equivalent to this by introducing a minus sign, which also affects the positive sign. And that is why it becomes identical. Therefore, A minus B and C minus B will be the factor of the factorization of the first one. That is the numerator. Then we take the denominator, C squared minus AC plus AB minus BC. Now, if you look at this, C is common, remaining C minus A. B is common, remaining A minus C. So this becomes C minus A into C plus B, or B plus C, whichever one. But in a sense, we can have this value here. Let's see what it is. You cannot give us any other thing. So this one can be written as minus A minus C into B plus C. And call this one the second one, that is the denominator. If you look at this very critically, we discover that dividing that, we have A minus B into C minus B all over minus A minus C into B plus C. But I just want to make it more aesthetic. So I will now do this. Minus A minus B. I will now interchange this one to become minus C minus A. So that the minus will cancel the minus, and then we have A minus B and then C minus A. And a final simplification. Thank you.